Everyone and welcome back. We are on part 4 of the Hautevilles campaign. Bohemond in the East. Without further ado, let's get on it and let's get started.
Bohemond never forgave Count Roger for siding with his younger brother. But other events would draw Bohemond away before he could threaten Norman unity. As bands of knights and foot soldiers passed through Sicily on their way to the Holy Land, Roger arranged for Bohemond to linger amongst them. Lured by the promises of lands and eternal glory on crusade, Bohemond too set out for the east. Bohemond retraced the path through the Byzantine Empire that he had taken only a few years before, while warring against the Emperor Alexios Komnenos. Now, however, he came to Constantinople as an honored guest before his old adversary, and promising to restore the Empire's territories in the Holy Land. Bohemond, of course, shared his father's cunning, and had no intention of following through with such a promise. When the Crusaders besieged the ancient city of Antioch, Bohemond resolved that it should be his. Mustering the cunning of his heritage, Bohemond told the Emperor's men that the other Crusaders planned to assassinate them, causing them to return home. He then bribed a local garrison commander to open Antioch's gates, but only after he had secured the sworn promises of the other Crusader princes that the first among them to enter the city would rule it. Unfortunately for Bohemond and the Crusaders, a great Turkish army was on its way. Already worn down by 8 long months of siege, Bohemond would need every ounce of his courage and his skill to survive.
Jeez, we can do it. Oh, just like that, we're in. Okay, cool. Right, let's get started. Okay, ensure that there's always at least one castle standing within the city walls of Antioch. Defend Antioch until the king arrives. Defend, secondary to defeat Ahmed Bum's garrison. Okay. Technology of 300 and can research both castle and imperial technologies. Okay, you'll not be able to train new villagers, however. Ouch. Okay. There's a rhythm to the siege. Use the breaks in the fighting to rebuild your defences, gather resources, and improve your army for next assault. Okay. The relics and the monasteries are the only source of gold. Stone could be found among the city's ancient ruins. Right. As the siege continues, you'll run low on available resources. Use the market to trade for what you need, but know that price inflation is inevitable. Yeah, fair enough. By taking the citadel from the garrison, you gain access to resources in the southern eastern hills. Okay. Researching faith and finding the Holy Lance provides a one-time temporary bonus for all units. Use it wisely. Okay. Fortunately for the Crusaders, Seljuk Turk warlord, it is light blue, has arrived with a massive army to retake the city. He has divided his army into several wings, surrounding the city's walls and 6 gates. His armies will attack in repeating waves and mixed troops. Despite his strength, Kerboga is hesitant to press his advantage, as too many casualties will break his diverse and pool from competing warlords. He instead will withdraw and reorganize for subsequent attacks and on a predictable schedule. Okay. Before Kerboga arrived, for the Crusaders could defeat the garrison entirely. Antioch Citadel in the east is still held by the Muslim garrison led by, which is the green, consistent of Mamluks, camel riders, archers, protected by the walls. While this garrison is unlikely to leave its position, making it less of a threat, it blocks access to additional resources beyond the hill. Okay, we need to kill the green. Finally, relieving the army by rumours on his way, likely to claim the city for the emperor. Bohemond was determined to push back the Turks. Okay, so we need to get into the city and defend.
Stay close to the walls, men. The Turks are trying to lure us out to be shot full of arrows.
Okay.
Never chase the Turks into the open. We will kill them at the walls.
Cool, what are we doing now?
Arrange to defend us. The Turks will attack again soon.
Okay, we need to get them up on there. Right, okay, so what do we need? We need stone. Let's get a couple of them. Okay, we need to kill this so we can get out the back and do it. Okay. Cool. Need a bit of stone. The enemy comes in 7 minutes. Okay, so we need to... I'm going to shut all the gates first, which could be quite handy to have. And we've got a little gold trickle coming in, which is not great, but it'll do. Okay, another thing there. Cool, same over there. Oh, we can build donjons. Okay, that could be quite handy to do. Maybe we should do that there, build a couple around here. Maybe come around here, build a couple. Might just get the, hang on. Got a market, okay. 10% faster, that could be quite handy. Maybe get rid of it for now. Cool, build that up. Infantry plus one attack, yep. And, oh wait, we want that to have extra range. Same with that. I think just get the upgrades quick.
Stop the video.
Why have you stopped the video? We're watching the PJ Players video.
I know, but we've got something really big we need to talk about.
Have we?
Yeah. We have an ambient music channel.
Oh yeah.
And we are very proud to announce that PJ TV has brought out a brand new channel completely separate from PJ Players, where we won't be gaming, we're just producing a whole bunch of music.
A whole bunch of music, ambience music, lots of reels, etc, etc. It is already live.
It's already
active. Go and check it out. We will be posting as often as we can.
You can do us a massive favor. You can subscribe to that channel, that'd be great. If you're not subscribed to this channel, what are you doing watching this video? If you've made it this far, you might as well subscribe. But if you could subscribe to that channel, that'd be great. And we've got socials across everything. We've got PJ TV socials, we've got PJ Ambience socials. We've just got so many socials, so you always know what we're doing.
Yes, and click that subscribe button and watch the stuff.
Okay, we'll let you carry on now. Bye.
Military buildings work fast, except these workshops. Yep, we definitely want that. Knights, it could be handy. Yes, we definitely want that. Donjons are little towers. Extra hit points could be vastly impressive. No, I want that. I want to kill that. And then... No, 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 no. Okay, that could be quite handy. Want to upgrade on them. How long we got left? I need stone, get on there quick. See how we get on.
Salutamo. The heathen comes. Show the Turks our resolve. Moratori, moratori. Ordi. Salutamo. Moratori, moratori, moratori.
Si. This is going to be interesting. No, why don't you kill that, mate? It's going to be so risky.
Signori. fate, signore? Comanni? Ho fatto. A vostro servizio. Lo capivo. Sì.
That is really not a good idea, was it?
Where is that Emperor Alexius? I almost regret bloodying him across Illyria, if this is his way to get vengeance against me.
Could this actually work? To attack ends, okay. How do we get a university? There must be a university in this somewhere. Yeah, definitely want that upgrade. Could sell some wood. How many come this way? That's interesting. I think we might be alright, actually. Hello? I don't think we should have broke the gate, but we can be able to build that back up again.
The Turks run. Let them go. We have much to rebuild.
Can we build anything? Can we build a university? We can't build a university. Okay, that's probably why. Yeah, I want to delete that. So I want to build another dungeon.
Soldiers, we fight and die here while the Byzantine Emperor dawdles. Never forget this Byzantine treachery.
Signore. Ordini.
Muratori. Salutamo.
Pronto. Okay, stone. Somewhere around here. Okay, yeah, build that, build that. Cool.
We have access to the rich hills behind Antioch. We should send the villagers there at once.
Get rid of that. We need a scout, scout, scout. Where can we get a scout?
My lord, the Emperor Alexios Komnenos has retired with his armies back to Constantinople. They believe us already dead.
He knows we are alive, and he knows I command the city. He is a spiteful coward, leaving us to die in the sand.
Cool. Right, we need to get some upgrades going. Okay. Might be all right, actually. Let's just see what's around here. Oh, some little goats, which is quite handy. Both gates are locked. Okay, that's good. Put them there.
A peasant claims that the holy lance that pierced Christ is buried in this city. I am skeptical, my lord, but the priests say we should have faith in this vision. At the very least, it will inspire the soldiers
research
to
faith.
Fight harder, if only for a short while.
Okay.
My lord should be tactical in choosing when to reveal this holy lance.
Oh, that's good. Got loads of gold. I think we could just get some stone so we can just build donjons and stuff, which would be excellent.
My lord, the holy lance has been revealed to the soldiers. They are inspired.
Oh. We shouldn't have done that. Never mind, it's done now. Can't do anything about it.
The heathen comes. Show the Turks our resolve.
Put them up here. Oh wow, okay. Just leave him out there for now. Just leave him there. Nice, this will do very, very nicely. We seem to get a bit of a good setup. Okay, rebuild that. Might build some donjons out here actually, that could be not a bad shout at all. Cool, do that. Sweet. Oh, there's a little bit more stone there. Nice, that'll do. I think I might build some more out here as well, just so we've got a bit of extra protection. That'd be wicked. Cool. Okay, we need to start building across there. There's a lot of wood down here. Go down this way. Cool. If we can go out here with this side, there's a bit of gold here. Cool, you can retreat back over here. That's fine. Bring that back over here. Yeah, I'm definitely going to build a couple of donjons up here. Last attack 1 minute 55. Need a couple of villages, eh? Stone, we're all right for stone. And I might build a couple out here actually, which could be quite handy.
Not even the Holy Lance is enough. The men are wavering.
Okay.
The Turks run. Let them go. We have much to rebuild.
Let's build a couple of these. Hang on. Running low on stone, but there's a market somewhere. I can't remember where it is. I think go, let's go out here. Get the upgrades. Let's get another one here and then actually. Right, I think it's time to get the elite stuff here. Oh yeah, here we go, a bit of stone there. Should be alright actually, just
a
Okay, yeah. We might be alright, actually. Got a we can sell some wood. Times are cruising. This is a little bit crazy, but it's okay. That has done absolutely nothing. So let's bring them up here. Bring them up here as well. Down here. Cool, I'll distract him for a bit. Going along here. They're just going to get hammered. Cool. Okay, not really sure what to do here. Probably mine the gold. And then... Okay. Bring him back over here. That's fine. I think we might have done it, to be honest with you, but we will see. I'm just going to leave these guys to it. It's more of this side, needs a little bit more micromanagement, to be honest. Kill that. Cool. Woohoo! Did we do it? Nice. We did it. Woohoo! Nice.
While Bohemond did not inherit his father's lands, he did inherit his attributes, and these won him a princedom. But Bohemond was not done after conquering Antioch. He sought every opportunity to conquer new lands. But his fearless aggression led him to being ambushed and captured by the Turks.
Oh dear.
His old enemy, the Emperor Alexios Komnenos, even offered to pay Bohemond's ransom if the Norman prince was brought to Constantinople in chains. Once again, Bohemond bested his old enemy, tricking his Turkish captors into releasing him for a smaller ransom. Years later, Bohemond again fought against the Emperor, but was surrounded by the Emperor's armies. He agreed to become a vassal of Emperor Alexios, but Bohemond's cunning had one last triumph. So that the treaty binding Bohemond to the Emperor would not include Antioch, Bohemond never again set foot in the city. He died in Sicily, leaving his son to succeed him in his hard-won eastern princedom.
It's a cool little story. Nice. And here we have it. Part 4 is done of the Hautevilles campaign. Now we're in part 5. Part 5, Wonder of the World. Seems really cool. And that'll be on our next video. Stay tuned. Give us a like, give us a share, give us a subscribe. Really, really appreciate all the work that people have been doing. Stay tuned. And we'll see you on the next one. Cheers, guys. Bye-bye.